Hi, welcome. Today we are going to study second point from the topic nuclear fission, and the point is the theory and process of nuclear fission. In the first part, we have seen that the phenomenon nuclear fission was discovered by Otto Hahn and Jeb Strassmann in January 1939. Otto Hahn also received a Nobel Prize for his contribution. After the discovery of nuclear fission, Meitner and Frisch, as well as Bohr and Wheeler, proposed a theory for the phenomenon of nuclear fission in 1939. And this theory is based on the liquid drop model of the nucleus. Now we will see what was that liquid drop model. So on this model, atomic nucleus is considered analogous to a drop of incompressible liquid. On this model, the atomic nucleus is considered analogous to a drop of incompressible liquid. Also, they have considered the size of atomic nucleus is proportional to number of nucleons present. So nucleons means protons plus neutrons. If number of nucleons are more in number, then size is larger, and if number of nucleons are less in number, then size is smaller. Then they have also considered that the shape is determined by two opposing forces. So the size is proportional to number of nucleons present, and shape is determined by two opposing forces. So these two forces are Coulomb force and the surface tension force. Now what is Coulomb force? So that Coulomb force, it distorts the shape due to interproton repulsion. So inside the nucleus there are protons. That protons repel each other, and due to that repelling they distort the shape of atomic nucleus. Opposite to that, there is a surface tension force. That surface tension force restore the spherical shape. So these two are the opposite forces which determine the shape of the atomic nucleus. One distort the shape and another restore the shape. Now we will see what is the actual process of nuclear fission. Now when the nucleus is excited by the capture of a neutron or by other means, here in this case consider that neutron, it bombarded with the uranium and we get excited uranium nucleus. So when the nucleus is excited by the capture of a neutron, oscillations are set up in the nucleus and a periodic distortion of shape takes place. So here periodic distortions are shown. So oscillations are set up in the nucleus and a periodic distortion of shape take place. Now we have shown the two routes. So this is when the excitation energy is not high enough, and this is when excitation energy is high. So when excitation energy is not high enough, the nucleus reverts to the initial near spherical shape and the excess energy is lost radiatively and may be followed by alpha decay. So in this case, as excitation energy is not high enough, that excited uranium shows alpha decay and form thorium having atomic mass 232. So this is the first case. Second case is that when excitation energy is high enough, so at that time the distortion increases. So initially it was spherical, then its shape goes on changing. It becomes, when we consider A, B, C and D, at C it become elliptical, then it become dumbbell shape, and there is a point reached when a critical deformation is reached and the two halves are separated. So if the excitation energy is high enough, the distortion increases from ellipsoidal to dumbbell shape till a critical deformation is reached. So this is the point where critical deformation, and that molecule or that nucleus is get splitted into the two halves and separate out as a fission fragment. So in this case we get that zirconium 95 and that tellurium 139. So these are the fission fission fragments, each having a spherical shape. Now the formed fragments undergo further beta emission. Here that is shown, the formed fragments undergo further beta emission till a stable nucleide isobaric with the primary fragment is reached. So in this case primary fragment is zirconium, in this case it is tellurium. So it undergo further beta emission up to where, till a stable nucleide which is isobaric with this primary fragment are formed. So this is the process of nuclear fission. So in this today's video we have seen actual theory and the process of nuclear fission. Thank you.